Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I would be grateful if you took a few moments to listen to the following short safety announcement. On hearing the fire alarm, we would ask everyone to evacuate the building immediately. Please leave in a calm and orderly manner using the exits which are located at the front and the rear of the hall. Then make your way to the assembly point at the front of the physics building located at the car park side of the hall opposite the main building. We would ask you to remain there until instructed otherwise. Please do not attempt to re-enter the building, even if the alarms have been silenced, as this does not always mean the emergency is over. I would also like to take this opportunity to ask you to silence all mobile phones now for the duration of this ceremony. Thank you for your cooperation, and we trust you enjoy your visit to Queen's University.
The world is changing at an unprecedented pace. Every industry is embracing change, drawing on a new wealth of insights and tools to advance in today's connected society. At Queen's University, we have a bold ambition to lead the way in the challenges we see ahead. Every day, we touch thousands of lives in our pursuit of excellence. Finding the solutions to real-world issues and inspiring research to have real-world impact. We are protecting the cybersecurity of billions of internet users. We are at the forefront of conflict resolution, making a difference to the lives of children, families, and communities across the world. We are working with industry to develop new technologies. We are creating access to safe, nutritious food for a growing population. And we're at the forefront of major medical breakthroughs, making a real impact on people's lives. We give amazing minds a place to do amazing things in a university fit for the 21st century. We are the heartbeat of one of Europe's fastest growing cities, in a country where the hospitality, welcome, and warmth of our people is legendary. Together, we are meeting the challenges of our time head on. Developing our students to be the leaders of tomorrow with the confidence and innovation to engage in an ever-evolving global culture. Together, we are shaping a better world.
Congratulations on your recent academic achievements and welcome to the Queen's Alumni community. I really hope that the sun is shining for you today, or that the rain isn't too bad. The successful completion of your degree is testament to your hard work and the support you've received from school and faculty staff, and of course, your friends, family, and your champions. I hope that you will be inspired by and remember your experience at Queen's as a student. I have no doubt that each one of you has the potential to achieve greatness, no matter where life takes you. You now join a distinguished network of over 200,000 past Queen's students who have enhanced and continue to enhance life in Northern Ireland and across the world. The impact of graduates can be seen through their contributions to business, healthcare, sport, engineering, social justice, and many, many more industries. I hope to have the opportunity to meet many of you in person at upcoming events over the months and years to follow, and to hear your stories as both a student and graduate. Wherever you travel, Queen's will continue to be part of your journey, sharing your success, supporting you through difficult times, highlighting exciting opportunities, and providing access to networks of graduates in your field of expertise. We'll keep you up to date as your relationship with Queen's transforms from a student for a few years to a graduate forever, and help you take advantage of the excellent ongoing support from the Careers, Employability and Skills team here at Queen's. But we can't do any of that if we don't know where to find you. Find some time today to make sure that we can continue to contact you by following the instructions on screen. You'll be glad you did. I'd like to offer you the warmest congratulations and best wishes for the future from everyone at the Development and Alumni Relations Office. We can't wait to hear all about the wonderful things you will do next.
Please rise to receive the academic procession.
Good afternoon and a warm welcome on this special occasion to graduands, parents, families and friends. I declare open this congregation for the conferment of degrees and presentation of diplomas and certificates. Please be seated. Colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, guests, friends, but most importantly of all, our graduands from the School of Arts, English and Languages. I'm delighted to have the opportunity of saying a few words to you this afternoon, not least because Arts, English and Languages is my home school, so it's a real privilege for me to be presiding at today's ceremony. And how wonderful it is to have our summer graduation back. Not a virtual event this time, but the real thing here in the Whitlaw Hall. That on its own is worth celebrating. Shortly, you'll step up onto the platform to receive your degrees, taking the final steps in a remarkable journey that began when you became first enrolled for your programme of study. From today, you'll have new letters after your name, a degree from Queen's, your passport to the future. When you first set off down the academic path, you did so, I'm sure, with excitement, anticipation, eagerness to learn. But there was also a sense of apprehension, starting a degree programme, whether it's undergraduate or postgraduate, can be exciting and terrifying in equal measure, which is probably exactly what makes it worth doing. This was all new territory. Challenges are always to be expected along the way. But little did any of us know just how big some of those would be. In fact, no one could have foreseen COVID and how it would impact on us all. But one thing we all learn at Queen's is how to be resilient. That resilience and your determination to succeed, whatever the challenge is, have led you to where you are today, graduates of this great university. I want to pay tribute to all of the people of Queen's, to our students, and to the staff in every part of this university. The way you responded to the crisis, how you adapted to new ways of living, studying, and working, how you kept your university going, it was truly remarkable. I think also of those hundreds of students across our health and social care professions who joined the workforce early to support the NHS. But there were students from schools all across the university, including the school here today, who volunteered in so many ways across a range of sectors. I think of our researchers, and of course there were many who were engaged in clinical trials, in vaccine development, working on research into new therapeutics. But COVID-related research took many other forms. For example, colleagues who have taught you throughout your degrees were leading projects to support the creative and cultural sectors as they learned to adapt and pivot. Others have analysed how an understanding of the languages of COVID have facilitated more effective communication of public health messaging to our multicultural and multilingual populations. All of this represents commitment and service to the community of the very highest order. So my congratulations and my thanks to all of you. You've made a huge contribution to the wider community and you've enhanced the reputation of your university. In this, you're the embodiment of our university motto, Pro tanto quid retribuamus, what shall we give in return for so much. Even in normal times, university life can be challenging. Undoubtedly, you'll have had some nervous moments along the way. Around exam time, deadlines are looming. We've all been there. And so the success you're celebrating today is a tribute not only to your academic achievements, but also to your determination and your ability to overcome all obstacles. Life at Queen's teaches us many things. One of the most beneficial is how important cooperation can be, what we can achieve when we work together as a team. And you have had a remarkable team around you and behind you. I'm thinking of those individual members of staff who did so much to guide you through, and of course also your family and friends who have been cheering you on the sidelines. They've all played their part, a really significant part. So why don't we thank all of the people on the stage behind me and the friends and family in the hall with you by giving them a very well-deserved round of applause. Today, as we celebrate the success of our graduating students, I'd particularly like to mention the family and friends of Jakub Bednarz. Jakub was a final year student of music and audio production who sadly passed away just as he was about to complete his degree. Jakub's parents, Peter and Beata, and his close family and friends are with us today. And you're all very welcome. Jakub began his studies at Queen's in September 2019 in pursuit of his passion for music. He was a particularly dedicated student who excelled in a wide range of creative practice and whose enthusiasm for and commitment to his studies were evident to all that had the privilege to know him. An equally talented musician, composer, and sound designer, all of Jakub's tutors recall his curiosity, his forensic attention to detail, and most importantly, his enormous generosity of spirit, for which he will be long remembered. Jakub's placement provider at Enter Yes Studio describes his passion, integrity, and energy, and how he became an important part of the team, the go-to guy for all things audio and sound. Jakub gave freely of his time supporting his peers and helping to promote the activities of the wider school. And we know that many of you here today valued him as a friend and colleague. Today, we will award a posthumous degree to Jakub in recognition of his achievements during his music studies at Queen's. And we hope that this will bring some comfort to Jakub's family and friends in the months and years ahead. The education of you, our graduands, helping you to reach your goals, creating and sustaining a world-class learning environment, these are the passions which motivate the people of this university at every level, every day. And Queen's is a continuing success story. In the recent Research Excellence Assessment, over 95% of our research environment was rated as world-leading or internationally recognised. And the landscape of the campus also continues to change. Just look at the new developments across the road at One Elmwood, our new student centre and students' union, a new landmark for Queen's and the City of Belfast. These are exciting times for our students. They are the lifeblood of our university, and you, our graduates, are the future of our society. You will grow into your careers with courage and conviction. You're empowered by your scholarship, and you've been tempered by the experience of living and working through one of the greatest crises our world has faced. You'll make a difference to the world around you because Queen's has made a difference to you. But leaving the university isn't the end, it's only the beginning. This part of your education is over, but always remember your capacity to learn, and the opportunities to do so are undiminished. Or as the American President Harry Truman once put it, it's what you learn after you know it all that counts. And so once again, my congratulations to you. I'm delighted that we're having this opportunity to celebrate with you, and I wish you all continued success in your future careers. For today, though, the focus is on celebration. It's a day for you and your family and for the friendships you've made here, some of which will last a lifetime. So enjoy today. You've earned it. Congratulations to you, and all best wishes for the future. Will all graduands please rise? In the name and by the authority of the university, I confer on you and those whose names appear on the graduation list the degrees, diplomas, and certificates to which you are entitled, and for which you who are present will be individually presented by your head of school. Please be seated.
Pro Vice Chancellor, I present to you candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in the School of Arts, English, and Languages. Ellen Fluga. Richard Anthony Gallagher. Katrina McGuire. Liam McCartan. And for the degree of Master of Arts in Arts Management, Sheena Kelly. Siobhan Patricia Kelly. Catherine Mary McKnight. Neve Ariana Wright. Zhenbo Lai. And for the Bachelor of Arts in Broadcast Production, Natasha Catalina Borman. Nicola Lauren Laura Helen Brown. Shannon Kate McGinnis McCarthy. Connor Maharg. Eve Adams. James Stephen Andrew Ballantyne. Thomas James Blythe. Tara Elizabeth Caldwell. Georgina Teresa Edmonds. Catherine Ann Goss. Samuel James Hamilton. Kaylee Ann Hughes. Aoife Catherine McGill. Yuste Mashekaiti. Alexander Thomas McCauley. Oshin Yu McCoy. Kai McHugh. Christine McVeigh. Ryan Murphy. Lynn Mary Daisy Porter. Andrew John Reed. Henry Simons. Ashling Maria Skillen. Ethan Aaron Tohill. Leisha Toye. Christopher James White. Samira Baraba. And for the Bachelor of Arts in Drama, Grace Feeney. Isabel Martin. Kira McMullen. Orla Teresa O'Kane. Aoife Noreen Rafferty. Alexandra Vivian Louisa Smith. Megan Elizabeth Stevenson. Antonia May Cameron. Alana Nicole Crawford. Megan Johnston. Lauren Victoria Jones. Ewan Samuel Charles McCartney. Charles Stewart McCready. Shannon Patricia McDonald. Matthew McTeague. Ethan O'Neill. Anna Marie Rooney. Caleb Smith Shannon. Jordan Mark Sherrard. Lauren Ray Rowena Smith. Caitlin McLaughlin. For the Bachelor of Arts in Film and Theater Making, Lauren Louise Bradley. Nora Evelina Helene. Luke Matthew McCormick. Tabitha Smith. Keelan Paul Stowe. For the Bachelor of Arts in Film Studies and Production, Jasper Banerjee. Max Blair. Emer Conway. Alexander Jack Donaldson. Freya Beatrice Ruby Elliott. Helen Maria Magarinos Green. Caitlin Joyce. Jamie Elizabeth Johanna Murray. James Howard Poston. Alice Marie Sarah Vincent. Ashley Rita Buma. India Carol Buma. Dearla Patricia Brady. Matthew Dylan Cregan. Leah Jane Cromwell. Peter Curry. Claudia Delgado Cambalia. Oliver Franson Lee. K. Cameron Daniel Jenkins. Niall Peter McGee. Claudia Marshall. Leah McCardle. Grania Mary McGurr. Neve Anna McKegney. Conal Martin McKenna. Joel Medwell. Erin Sancha Mills. Jack Henry Parkin. Jamie Robbins. B. Soriano. Chelsea Todd. Jody Vance. Jennifer Paula Walsh. Oren Tomas Wright. Amy McGuire. For the Bachelor of Arts in Music Performance, Aaron Daniel Farry. Darcy Wilders. For the Bachelor of Arts in Music and Audio Production, Anna Marie Louise Ledgewood. Lee Russell. Dara Shane Zola Tibbs. Kenneth Maurice Okoso Offel. Ross Falconer. Emma Ruth Gibson. Jonathan McElroy. Rhiannon Mary Mulligan. Thomas Alexander Monroe. Aiden Shepherd. Cahill Francis Patrick Turton. Rebecca Bridget Agnew. Harry Thomas Rowe. For the Bachelor of Arts in Music and Sound Design, Simon Patrick Campbell. Leon Brian Thomas Crockett. Caitlin Jane Green. Mackenzie Hunter. Amy Janet Jordan. Brian Paul Lincoln. Harry McEachern. Stephen George Murphy. Andrew Fenix. Lauren Slyth. For the Bachelor of Arts in Drama and English, Josephine Cox. Ethan Andrew Kenny. Chloe Anna McCullough. Jamie Bonner. Molly Nicole Rutherford. For the degree of Bachelor of Music, Lewis Aiken. Kaylee Rosanna Colson Rice. Peter Deveni. Constance Elizabeth Gavin. Abby Victoria Ann Gillespie. Hannah Harvey. Catherine Elizabeth Hill. Katie Lyons. Breege McCary. Jake McCray. Mark Lewis McKibben. Lindsay Mitchell. Colm Joseph Moen. Amelia Kate Williams. Alex Eileen Annett. Catherine Elizabeth Ann Bingham. Jonathan Dempster. Jamie Donnelly. Oren Patrick McBrien. Charles Francis McCartan. Dyreen McCauley. Olivia McClenahan. Neve McCloskey. Aaron McNally. Anna Kate McWaters. Seth Isaac O'Donovan. Eve Marie O'Neill. Aaron Sean Patton. Konstantinos Petros Petsakos. Yeah. Holly Rhonda Farlow. And for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Audio Engineering, Samuel David McElmoyle. Thomas Harry McCormick. Matthew James Todd. And finally, it is with great sadness and pride that we confer the posthumous award of Bachelor of Arts in Music and Audio Production to Jakub Bednarz.
Thank you very much, everyone. And congratulations again to all of you on reaching this very, very significant milestone. We have really enjoyed the privilege of sharing this celebration with you. As a university, we're extremely proud of what you've achieved, and we hope that you're proud of your university. As a graduate, you'll always remain part of the Queen's community, so please do stay in touch with the university through our Development and Alumni Relations Office. Make the most of all the opportunities that continue to be available to you as graduates. I wish you every success for the future. I hope it's exciting and challenging in equal measure. I look forward to hearing about your achievements over the coming years. Remember, though, the words of Alvin Toffler, American writer, futurist, and businessman, who said, "It's better to err on the side of daring than the side of caution." So enjoy the rest of today, then go out and be daring. You're the future, and you can change the world. Before we close today's ceremony, there are just a few other people who'd like to add their congratulations.
So, to all the Masters in Arts Management graduates who are stepping across that stage this summer, congratulations. You've worked really hard for this. We're really proud of you.
Just wanted to pop in and congratulate you on making it this far. You've proved yourselves really resilient, so onwards and upwards from here.
Many congratulations on your achievement. I wish you a wonderful day with family and friends and all the best in the future.
Congratulations to everyone graduating today. I'm particularly proud of all you guys graduating from the BA in Broadcast Production. You're going to do great out there, guys, so good luck.
We are all really proud of your accomplishments. Take some time to really appreciate what you have accomplished today.
I just want to congratulate everyone on completing their degrees. And you've been through some challenging times, but just think of all of the ways that will allow you to answer difficult questions in interviews.
Big congratulations on graduating and making your final films. It's been a real privilege to work with you.
I want every one of you to be proud of yourselves, of your achievement, and we as a Queen's community are really delighted we've been able to support you on your journey.
Just to wish you massive congratulations on this fantastic day. You should be really proud of everything that you've achieved in your time here at Queen's.
Katrina, congratulations on graduating with your PhD. It's been a privilege and a delight to supervise you and to follow your path.
Congratulations and well done. I've been really blown away by the energy and enthusiasm that you finished your degree with. I have two pieces of advice for you. The first piece is celebrate every win, no matter how small. And the second piece of advice is, most of the time, don't take advice. Just trust yourself. Go your own way.
It's As Chancellor of Queen's University, I would like to offer my sincere congratulations to all of our graduating students. After 2 years without summer graduations, I'm delighted that you can all celebrate together in person to mark this very special occasion. You know, graduation is a significant milestone in every student's career, and today is an opportunity for the university to formally recognize your hard work and congratulate you on your success. Your graduation is even more special as the circumstances in which you've completed your studies has made your achievements simply remarkable. I know the journey has not been easy, but you've demonstrated incredible resilience, agility, and determination in adapting to new circumstances to achieve your goals. You're graduating at a time of major challenges and change across the world, but it's also, I believe, a time of great opportunity and potential. So, class of 2022, please use your knowledge, your skills, your talents to help us shape a better world. Our society needs people like each of you, creative, critically good at thinking and doing, problem solvers who can make real differences in transforming lives and societies. So as you close this important chapter in your life and begin a new one, I wish you the very, very best as you go out into that world that awaits. Please be a force for positive change and always be proud of the fact that you are a Queen's graduate, because Queen's is certainly proud of you, as are your parents, families, and friends celebrating with you today. Congratulations again, and best wishes for every success in the future.
I declare closed this congregation for the conferment of degrees and presentation of diplomas and certificates, and invite our new graduates and recipients to join the academic procession as it leaves the hall. Could I ask parents and friends to wait until the procession has left? Thank you.
Queen's Alumni Office was established to ensure that the relationship between graduates and alma mater becomes lifelong. Many people will have forged lasting personal and professional friendships while at Queen's, and the ongoing alumni outreach programme aims to keep Queen's men and Queen's women in touch with the university and, of course, with each other. In time, alumni will make return visits to Queen's for reunions, public lectures, social and academic events, and perhaps further study. It's particularly important to stay in contact if careers are pursued overseas, and for this reason, Queen's now has a number of graduate organisations based both here in Northern Ireland and throughout the world in Canada, America, the Far East, Africa, and Northern Europe. So, graduation should not mark the end of your association with Queen's. Through the Alumni Office, those friends, contacts, and memories can last a lifetime.